Good evening, everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, depending on where you are located around the world. What's happening? Yesterday, I worked on refactoring the render and the entity. Relationship, that means that I want to decouple the logic from the update loop from the render loop, and this is a huge transformation for me because this refactoring would allow me to apply custom geometric transformation to any asset, whether it's vector or sprite based. And so far I have I haven't developed anything in this direction. I was just experimenting with temporary code, but right now I'm gonna get my hands dirty because I have to do this until my kid arrives, because she's going to test this particular feature by playing. And the reason I needed this separation of concerns is because I started adding power-ups, and the power-ups just modify the behavior of certain actions, like dropping a bomb or eating food. And in order to be able at some point to actually, the real trigger for this separation of concerns were the scores, and the fact that I want to have dropping scores just like in Secret of Mana. And because the score is an entity, I had to come up with a way of making an entity behave in a certain way, geometrically speaking. Whatever. Without further ado, I'm gonna start refactoring. So, I'm gonna create a tag here. Because I'm in Windows, I think I'm going to tag it from work on detecting on update render separ loop. Let me see, do I have any other tags here? don't have much to say on this particular version, but I prefer to tag this before starting work, because at some point I want to go back to the original version, maybe just to demonstrate some of the concepts. Alright, so let's see, where is the... let's put this here. A geometry will apply to entity and entity body on inference body. Okay, let's take into this. Geometry drop and bounce. So basically we need an update method. I still think we need to pass the body, but I'll see about this. So this will apply to body, okay, a state can transform, okay. So let's see, drop and bounce can influence the way update behaves. So I'm just going to start with a score entity. Number which needs to bounce with the animation. Okay, we have this animation. We want to call this animation. I think I want to call it transform. It's not really an animation. And geometric transform is too let's call it transform. So let's see, we have the width, the height.
provide the starting position and the limit.
Let's go with the chords. And the limit should be, let's say, it can bounce 100 pixels. Something like this. And then with each tick, we just do this transformation. And then this will be picked up later. Transformation to update. What I don't like about this is that it should pass the new X and Y. Let's just do it like this. And later we'll do it the right way. We'll do this update inside. We'll pass the body as a reference and so on.
Okay.
Core number, we should first make a test of this. So when this is done, should destroy the score. So let's add the for the sake of testing, let's add a sprite. Let's create some dummy. Dummy sprites for scores. So let's say we have one to represent points. Let's say we just create a sprite for testing the scores like this. It doesn't matter how this looks. Okay, and we'll have this added to the game so that this number will pop out of any fruit or any food that the player eats. Let's take the position of this and do a sprite configuration out of this. Okay. So what we want is when the player will eat something, the score will pop and bounce. The score will pop and bounce. Okay. I need okay, the music is too music was too engaging for what I'm doing here.
not the client. I need to load. I need to load. The score. Let's take, what should I take as an example? This one. Okay, so I have score number. This is just an entity, and I said I needed the start. Start. Okay, this will be just temporarily. Okay, attack damage, vision radius, body 16, 16. The default animation for the scores is bounce, is not idle. Although they only have one animation so far. Speed ticks, I don't care about speed ticks. Okay, so I'm loading the score number. And someone has to generate the score. So in the eating process, in the player states, I will actually spawn a new score. So he's eating, player eat food. I wonder, because I forgot, I wonder who else is listening for this event. Oh, it's the scores, the custom scores are listening for this. Okay, now I have to be reminded. How I create a new map object, so it's by make entity map object. All right, so who's using this, because I need a model here. So I have the API with the add entity, which is great. Oh, I could do it straight from here. I could do it straight from here, actually. Okay, let's start everything. Okay, running the dev server. Right, so apparently this console log here. So I will use the API of the game. Score number, and let's give it a 300. Let's see what happens. Can I read property init of null? Okay, then the factory is not the factory, is the map service. So map service doesn't have it here. Of course, this is again temporary. This list should not be bound to the engine. Break. Okay, so what if I spawn it right now? Nothing is rendered because we didn't update the sprite. That's actually funny. And behold the power-ups. I have an idea here. I have an idea. Now that I have an API for everything, I can do whatever I want, and that's a good pattern for every software out there. When you're they say that you have to eat your own dog food, right? So when you're consuming your own application and you become the client of your own application, it's much more easy to debug everything and to find customer issues early on. Okay, let's do something like this. Bam. I still need to shorten it. think I need to delete one pixel here, and I think 2 pixels from here, like this. I'm not sure if I'm saving money if I do this by myself. I prefer these to be done by Tom, the designer. Oh god. So again, flatten. I mean, I wanna learn pixel art and everything, but first I have to release the game. And then I make time to learn these techniques. Arrange. Okay, bring to front. I'm just curious if this looks different. I could potentially save some money with this. It's interesting that I think I have to random it a little bit better. Check this out. Bam, 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 bam. And now I'm really curious. Service entities. So these core numbers didn't disappear. Oh, because I didn't tell them to disappear. I see what I did there. Oh, so this is good actually that I've done this, because the score needs two states. One where it bounces, and one where it disappears. This is quite fascinating for me, actually. I wasn't expecting it to be this interesting. So, what if I do... What if I multiply this, like... Duplicate, actually, not multiply. Because anyway, I got fixed scores, so I will have something like 10, 30, 20. So what if this... Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 6, let's make it 9. 3, 3, and one more. Okay. So what if this starts from the top? Like from here? And they slowly go down. this, then this, oh, then this, which is the actual position. Then this comes here. Then this comes here. But it has to come back. It has to come back to this. This is incorrect here. Coming back. Going top. Coming back. Okay. I'm okay with this. Let's see how this looks. If it creates the illusion of bouncing. And then we take this. And we create a different state where the number will actually fade away. Like this. 50. Then again 50. Okay, let's try this just for fun. Again, I'm not a designer, so I'm just trying this to know what to require for my designer, from my designer. So I will need to modify the animation here. So the bounce right now will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 frames. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And we'll have bounce and disappear. Spelled this? Disappear. Bounce and disappear. Okay. And this will be much more slower. So I want the disappearing to take some time. Nice. Okay, so now a score can bounce and then can disappear. Score number disappear. Am I writing this correctly? Disappear. No. Disappear. Disappear. Okay, with the priority of. So this has the priority of 2. Bounce has the priority of. Okay, I will not apply any transformation to this one. No transformations required here, just render it and let's see here. How do I trigger another state? Oh, like this. So you trigger it. Great. So player states. Okay. Let's see. We want the score to bounce when it finished bouncing. We want it to migrate to the other state. So let's see if this update tick bigger than 120. This score this exit. Okay. To destroy it here. We want to destroy the score when it disappears here, which is correct. So let's register the state. Disappear score number. Disappear. Okay, we can import it. We don't want it to have any transformations, at least yet. And we want to see it in action. So I think we need less fruits here. Let me see. Okay, there are some animation problems, but I mean that can those can be fixed in the by the designer. And we want to exit if this update take bigger than say 120, this exit. And this should also destroy the score. Okay. And we got scores, ladies and gentlemen. We got scores with bouncing effect, just like in Spirit of Mana, in the Secret of Mana. And if I want, I can actually randomize the way the scores bounce. So let's do something crazy here. Let's go to our API. And instead of odd entity, let's do a something crazy. Random scores.
So now we can spawn random scores just to see how this looks. I think I want a little bit of delay between them. That's actually cool, man. And the fact that we can do that in an instant is really nice. It's raining scores. Can have any type of transformation. This should be score number, so these are the scores. Move it here, okay, and then go to and do single player 50. Score number 50, score number 50, and no, I'm not doing this correctly. So score number entity scores, so I need to provide the blueprint. And the blueprint is the score number 50. And this should be indeed score number 50. Okay. No doubt about it. And when I'm loading here, spawn random scores, should do something like score number 50, and then we'll randomize the number.
So if I want score number 100, I think I can make this fit in here. And you can still see it's 100. This. Hi, Focus VIP. What's happening? What? Do you have any news? What are you doing? Any new things that you're doing? By the way, check this out. I want to share something that I'm working on. So I'm working on applying geometric transformations to any entity. So if I want to say I want to spawn a score, I want it to bounce. So if I want to have scores that bounce, I just apply the bounce transformation to the score entity. And now I'm just messing around with some score sprites. I actually need a lot of transformations for food, also for a lot of objects, but so far I only have one geometric transformation, and I'm also testing some of the animation principles that I want to propose to the designer. So this is why I'm doing things manually here. I want to see how a bounce animation would look like in this context. So let's see, say that this 100 comes from the top and starts to fall, but one is heavier than the other. One falls, these two are the same now. So one falls, but it falls deeper, this falls. Okay. One is on this level. Same level, same level. This falls, now they're all set. So let's say that we have this sort of animation. Can we do a little more? Nah. Okay, and now we do the fade out trick. Focus VIP, are you working on something new? Something that you have to show? I'm curious. Just freaking curious. 50, and now we just alternate this. Oops. When I say alternate, I really mean alternate. Right. So now we have 100. I still wonder if this visual is correct. But whatever. I can live with this. Okay, now we have score. Copy paste score 100. Bounce, and the offset would be 96. Excellent. Let's do a duplicate of this and put 100. Okay. We have these loaded and we can call the API. Food manager, client control. Let's call the API here, so we have zero and scores length, so -1. I think this is much more correct because I might have multiple scores in the future. I also want to make the same test with a different kind of score. Like bonus scores. I think the scores are visible. Maybe they should be bigger than this, but
I'm just gonna let the designer choose this particular thing. Okay, now what happens when there's another concept that I want to introduce in the game, the concept of combo. And the combo should be I have to get rid of this. The combo should appear when you eat or you eliminate more than one adversary in a row in a certain amount of time. So let's see, player TS. Just don't want this anymore. Or maybe I want them commented. Why can't I place any bomb?
Delicious! Yummy!
Did I change something? Okay, so I have to figure out if I change anything to the player states, because what do you know, apparently laying a bomb is not available anymore. I have no idea why is that. Let's clear the storage for a second. Okay, so that's okay, and let's see what else we have in the grand scheme of things. So we did this. Coupling. And now the heavy part with refactoring. The entity sprite, but you know what, I have a different idea. Or maybe not. Channel name, walk, save needed for. Actually, you know what, I could skip the step with the removing the entity sprite in order to do this, and do this only when I have these interfaces ready. Let me think about it. Do I really want to invent new things right now? That's the big question. If I can apply a transformation to my object, do I really need this part now? That's the big question, the major question. Because I might be better off trying to find new geometric transformations that could be good. So let's see. So the player grabs the instant, the insta eat. And let's see. The player grabs the insta eat. I see. feel like the eating process is too at least the instant eating process is too stale. I think I'm better off with what? Oh, okay. I feel like I should do more transformations than rather than bothering with the decoupling of rendering from the update logic right now. I mean, surely that's a great idea, but I still have a game to finish. So better focus on that. Okay, so I have to leave for a second, so
Okay, so in this session I've implemented the scores and also the transformation, geometry transformation class, which can be applied to any object in game. We're gonna have fun in the next session. Now I'm going to eat and come back in half an hour maximum. Thanks for watching. See you later.